guys, this Medicos Library video for you. Topic is esophagus surgical anatomy. Let's begin. Esophagus is 20 cm length, which starts at cricopharyngeal sphincter and ends at cardioesophageal junction. It runs in the posterior mediastinum as continuation of pharynx. 2 cm of this tube lies below the diaphragm. Let's see the constrictions. It is 50 cm distant from the incisor. The constriction is cricopharyngeal constriction. Aortic and bronchial constriction is from 25 cm distance from the incisor teeth. Diaphragmatic sphincter is at 40 cm distance from the incisor teeth. Let's see the muscle layer. Its inner is circular muscle, outer is longitudinal muscle fibers. Upper third of esophagus consists of striated muscle fibers. Middle third consists of striated and smooth muscles. Lower third consists of smooth muscle fibers. Mucosa. Mucosa is the toughest coat of esophagus. Entire mucosa is lined by squamous epithelium, whereas last 3 cm is lined by columnar cells. Columnar cells are same as gastric mucosa, but oxyntic and peptic cells are absent. Let's see the esophagus sphincter. There are 2 esophagus sphincters, upper esophagus sphincter and lower esophagus sphincter. Upper esophagus sphincter is anatomically striated muscle sphincter at the junction between pharynx and esophagus. It produced by cricopharyngeal muscle. Normally it is constricted to prevent the entrance of air into esophagus. Lower esophagus sphincter. It is physiological sphincter located in the gastroesophageal junction between stomach and esophagus. The gastroesophageal junction is situated to the left of the T-level vertebrae and is marked by the change from esophageal to gastric mucosa. Let's see the blood supply. Blood supply in thoracic region is by thoracic aorta and inferior thyroid artery. And its venous blood supply is by branch of azygos and inferior thyroid vein. In the abdominal area, the artery supply is by left gastric artery, which is a branch of celiac trunk, and left phrenic artery. And venous supply is here is mixed venous drainage by 2 routes. The first route is portal circulation via left gastric vein. Second route is systematic circulation via azygous vein. 2 routes form a protosystemic anastomosis, connection between portal and systemic venous systems. And next we'll see the nerve supply. Parasympathetic nerve supply is by vagus nerve through extrinsic and intrinsic flexes. Intrinsic flexes has no muscular network. Parabronchial flexes is presented only in the lower third of the esophagus. At last we see the lymphatic drainage. Upper esophagus drains into left and right clavicular nodes. Middle esophagus drains in the tracheobronchial nodes and paraesophageal nodes. Lower esophagus drains into lymph nodes along the lesser curvature of the stomach and then in the celiac nodes. I hope this video helps you. Please like, share and subscribe.